today topic is capital reduction under public finance and taxation. Obviously, my name is Deco Mohammed. I welcome you. So today, under capital reduction, we have several reductions. We may have the investment reduction, industrial billing reduction, we have the wear and tear, and also the farm work reduction. Here on the board, I'm having a question that was tested in November 2015, question 4 under CASNEP. But before I do that illustration, I would like to show the format or how do we go about those deductions. The format of how we go about those deductions. If I begin with the first one, the investment deduction. If I have here the investment deduction, investment deduction. Normally, we have the nature of asset. Then we have the, this is investment deduction, ID, investment deduction. After the nature of asset, we have the qualifying cost. Then we get the ID rate. Then the ID value. Therefore, we may have an example. Let's say factory billing. So you write the qualifying cost here, the qualifying cost. Then normally the rate for investment deduction is 100%. These rates are given in the question, the first page before question one. Normally all the rest are given. So the rate for this is 100%. Now subject qualifying cost to get the ID value. We may have the processing machinery. Do the same. The rate is 100. You get the ID value. We may have the conveyor belt. You do the same. 100%. You get like that. We may have water pump. You do the same. The head is 100. Like that. We also have the borehole. 100%. Then you get the total. You get the total here and the total. Now that's all about the investment deduction. Nature of the asset, the qualifying cost, the ID rate, and the ID value. I like to go to the next deduction, the industrial billing deduction. Let's have the industrial building deduction. Let's say IBD, the industrial building deduction. We have nature of building. Then you get the qualifying cost. Then you get the IBD rate. Then the IBD value. Then you get the balance. Let's say we have showroom, you write there the qualifying cost, The IBD rate for showroom is 25%. Normally it is given in the equations. Then the IBD value subject 25% to the qualifying cost. You will get the IBD value. For you to get the balance, you take the qualifying cost, subtract from the ID, from the IBD value, you get the balance. Maybe we have also, let's say, shop. You do the same. The IBD rate is 25%. The IBD value subject 25% to the cost, you get this amount, then subtract cost from the ID value, IBD value, you will get the balance. Lastly, let's say we have staff quotas. Staff quotas. Right here, the qualifying cost, the IBD rate for staff quotas is 10%. Then the IBD value, then you get the balance. Then you can get now the summation of the qualifying cost and also the IBD value. So that's all about the industrial building reduction. Nature of the building, qualifying cost, the IBD rate, IBD value, and the balance. Lastly, I want to show the wear and tear. Wear and tear allowance. Okay? Normally, we have five classes. We have the class 1, class 2, class 3, class 4, and class 5. Class 5 are normally for software. So, you write the class here, class 1. Normally, class 1, the percentage attached to class 1 is 37.5. We have class 2, the percentage for class 2 is 30%. We have the class 3, the percentage attached to class 3 is 25%. Lastly, we have the class 4, the percentage is 12.5. We also have class 5, which is 20. Let's say class 5. 20%. Therefore, after writing the class for each 1 to 5, you get the written down value. Written down value as at first, the opening written down value. Let's say written down value as at first January. Let's say it is 2018. If it is 2018, first January 2018, the written down value as at first January. You write for each class, for each class. Then you go for additions. Then you list them. Any class 1, class 2, class 3, class 4, class 5 you may have. Let's say we have three-ton lorry. That is a class 1. Let's say we have saloon car. That is a class 3. Saloon car is a class 3. Right there, as class 3. Then, let's say we have the computer. Computer is a class 2, right under class 2. Let's say furniture and fittings, that's a class 4. Then, let's say software, we have software. Computer software is a class 5. If there is any disposal, you less. Maybe the saloon car was disposed. Let's say saloon car. If you are disposed, you subtract. But remember, the saloon car, the non-commercial vehicle like saloon car, has a restricted amount of 2 million. If you may find in the question, the saloon car, the amount is bigger than 2 million, you restrict to 2 million. You don't write more than 2 million. Then getting the disposal, you take the restricted value of 2 million, then you divide with the original amount, then multiply it with the disposal. You get the disposal. Then subtract it, you will get now now you total. If there is any, if there is any other class 1, class 2, class 3, class 4, you continue. Mine, the space is minimal. It may not allow. But if you have another class 2, you continue like that before the before disposal, you continue. Then you get the sum. You sum up like this. This will be the sum summation for class 1, class 2, class 3, class 4, class 5. Then you get the wear and tear. Wear and tear, you subject these percentages to this amount, the total amount for class 1. Let's say it was 500,000. You take that 7.5 times that 500. Then you get that wear and tear. Then subtract the wear and tear from this cost. You will get the written down value as 31st December, let's say 2018. You do the same for class 2. You get the total, then subject to 30%. That will give you the wear and tear allowance. Then subtract this amount from wear and tear, you will get the written down value as the 31st December. The same for class 3, class 4, and class 5. That was a brief illustration showing how they look like. The investment deduction, the industrial building deduction, the wear and tear allowance. Now, I want to illustrate the question. At least now we have clue of what capital reduction looks like. Now let me illustrate a question that was tested under CASTNET in November 2015. Question 4C. We are told PESA Limited, for those who can download the question, you can download it, it's free. November 2015, question 4C. PESA Limited commenced our manufacturing on 1st January 2014 after incurring the following capital expenditure. We have the factory building, 8 million, processing machinery, 2,400,000, saloon car, 2,800,000, neon advertising sign, 48,000, computers, 150,000, delivery van, 960,000, furniture and fittings, 200,000, water tank, 90,000, water pump, 40,000, computer software, 120,000, lorry, 3 ton, 2,750,000. Additional information, number 1, factory building include a dwelling house of 1,180,000 and a commercial building comprising of office of 1,200,000, commercial building comprising of an office of 1,200,000, comma, a shop of 800,000, and a showroom of 600,000. Then number 2, processing machinery exclude an interest on loan of 240,000, paid for a loan of 2,000,000, used to acquire the machinery and installation cost amounting to 60,000. Number 3, a saloon car was disposed of on 1st December 2014 for shilling 1,800,000. Number 4, a staff canteen constructed during the year at a cost of 840,000 was put to use on 1st September 2014. Number 5, a section of workers burned down by fire had been renovated at a cost of 1,500,000. The remaining section, which was not affected by the fire, had been valued by an insurance company at shilling 1 million. The workers' quarters were reoccupied on 1st October 2014. Then you are told, required capital allowances due to PESA Limited for the year ended that 1st December, that 1st December 2014. The capital allowances. Now, you can show now the question. You can illustrate the question. We are told the capital allowances. We are required to show the capital allowances. This question, there are some which require workings, adjustments. If you look at the factory building,
additional information number one will affect the factory building. Processing machinery, number two, additional information number two will affect our processing machinery. And also number five, the workers' quarters also has an adjustment. Now I like to show those adjustments so that we get the qualifying cost for each, so that we can use to illustrate the capital allowances. Let's say working one. Let's start with the qualifying cost. Qualifying cost for factory building. Factory building. Qualifying cost for factory building. We are told here we have factory building. The amount is, let's see here, factory building. The amount there we have is 8 million. We have 8 million. But we are told in additional information number one, factory building include a dwelling house of 1,180,000, a commercial building office of 1,200,000, a shop of 800, and a showroom of 600. So we need to subtract these values from 8 million. Let's say less. We have the dwelling house. Dwelling house. The amount there is 1,180,000. Next one is office of how much? The office there is 1,200,000. The amount for shop is 800,000. After the shop, we have a showroom of how much? 600,000. Now we need to add, sum up this, then we subtract the total from 8 million. If I add 1180, add to 1,200,000, you add to 800, you add to 600. 3 million, I'm getting 3,780,000. Then subtract it from 8 million. 8 million from the answer. I'm getting 4,220,000. That is the qualifying cost for factory building. Now working two, we are going to get the qualifying cost for processing machinery. I want to wrap this place, so let me write the amount on top of there so that if I wrap, I'll still remember the value for factory building. So we have factory building, the amount here is 4,220,000. Now let me wrap. Working two. Let's have the working two. Qualifying cost for processing machinery. Processing machinery. Therefore, let's have the processing machinery, the initial cost. Processing machinery cost, the amount was 2,400,000. Then remember, additional information number two, we are told processing machinery exclude an interest of loan of 240,000 paid for a loan of 2 million used to acquire the machinery and installation cost of amounting to 60,000. This machinery cost, it excludes the interest on loan, so we need to add back the interest on loan. Also, there is an installation cost, additional cost, we need to add back also to the cost. Therefore, you see,
they add interest on loan of how much? The interest on loan is 240,000. 240,000. You have the installation cost. Installation cost of how much? The installation cost of 60,000. 60,000. So 60 plus 240, that comes to 300,000. Then if I add 2,400,000 to 300, you will get 2,700,000. That is working two. Working two. Lastly, let's have the working three. Qualifying cost for quotas, for workers' quotas, for workers' quotas. So, workers' quotas, we are told, number five, a section of workers' quotas burned down by fire had been renovated at a cost of 1,500,000. The remaining section, which was not affected by the fire, had been valued by an insurance company at shilling 1 million. The workers' quarters were reoccupied on 1st October 2014. Therefore, we have the renovation cost, renovation cost. The amount for renovation cost is 1,500,000. Then we have the insurance of 1 million. Total, I'm getting 2,500,000. That is the qualifying cost for workers' quotas. Now we are done with the workings. We know the qualifying cost for processing machinery. We know for factory building. We also know for workers' quotas. Now, I want to write this side, so we illustrate the question now. The working, the capital reduction. Therefore, let me write these figures up there so that we are going to use them later. The processing machinery is 2 million. Processing machinery is 2,700,000. The workers' quotas is 2,500,000. Workers' quotas is 2,500,000. But remember, we are told here, number five, they were reoccupied on 1st October. So 1st October 2014. They were reoccupied on 1st October 2014. Lastly, staff canteen, the amount is 840. So let's have here staff canteen, 840. We are told it was put into use on 1st September 2014. The workers' quarters were occupied on 1st October 2014. That means we are going to show October, November, December, 3 months. And also, the staff canteen, 1st September 2014. That means September, October, November, December, 4 months. So I have written out everything there. The factory building, the processing machinery, the workers' quarters, and also the staff canteen. Now I can wrap this side so that we illustrate the question. Allow me to wrap. So, let's start with the investment reduction. We're going to have nature of asset. Investment reduction, we're going to have the nature of asset. We're also going to have the qualifying cost. Remember, this is ID in investment reduction. So let's have the ID rate, then the ID value. So remember, we are having the factory building as the first asset. Factory building, factory. The amount for factory building, we showed the workings was 4,220,000. The ID rate for investment reduction is 100%. This rate are normally given in the question. Value, subject 100 to this cost, you will get still the same amount, 4,220,000. Then we have the processing machinery. Processing machinery. The amount, we showed the workings, it was 2,700,000. The qualifying cost is 100%. Then that will give us 2,700,000. We look, is there any other investment reduction? If you look at the question, we have the water pump. In the water pump, we have 40,000 as the amount. 40,000. If you subject at 100%, you still get 40%. That is all about. I'm not seeing any other investment reduction. That's all about in this question, the investment reduction. So we add. If I take 4,220, add to 2,700, add to 40, I'm getting 6,960,000. The same with this side, 6,960,000. So that's all about the investment reduction. Let me go to the next capital allowance, which is industrial building reduction, which is IBD, the industrial building deduction. So we're going to have the nature of building. Then we're going to have the qualifying cost. After the qualifying cost, we're going to have the IBD rate, the rate for industrial building deduction. Then after the rate, we get IBD value. Then we get lastly the balance. So remember, here in the question, we are having an office of 1,200. Let's have office. The amount is 1,200,000. Remember, the rate for office normally is 25. These rates are given in the question, so you don't have to worry about it. Then 25%. So now we take 25% of 1,200,000. That's going to give us how much? 25 divided by 100, multiplied by 1,200,000. I'm getting 300,000. 300,000. For me to get the balance, I take 1,200,000 subtract from 300. So 1,200,000 minus 300,000. The difference is 900. That is the balance, 900,000. The next industrial building reduction, is shop. The qualifying cost was 800,000. From the question, we are having at 800,000, 25%. Then, if I take 25
over 100 multiplied by 800,000, getting 200,000. Subtract 800 from 200, you'll get 600,000. After the shop, the next industrial building induction is showroom. We have showroom. Showroom, the amount is 600,000. 600,000. Subject to 25%. Then if I take 25.25 times 600,000, I'm getting 150,000. Then subtract 600 from 150, subtract 600 from 150. The amount is 450,000. So now we go on number three. I wrote here the additional information, but we already know the workers' quarters. Before that, we also have the water tank. We have here water tank. We have water tank. The amount for water tank is 90,000. 90,000. IDB rate is 10%. So 10 over 100 times 90,000. 10 divided by 100 times 90,000. The amount is 9,000. 9,000. Then subtract 90,000 from 9,000. You'll get 81,000. 81. So we are having additional information number 4 and 5, which was about the workers' quarters and the staff. It was about the workers' quarters and also the staff canteen. Remember, we calculated the workers' quarters. We calculated the qualifying cost, whereby, we were having the renovation cost of 1,500 and insurance of 1 million. We just coming to 2,500,000. So, workers' quarters. We calculated the qualifying cost as 2,500,000. The IBD rate is 10%, but in the question we are told they were reoccupied on these workers' quarters on 1st October. I remember it was 1st October. Now it means it was October, November, December, only 3 months. So it means we are going to multiply by 3 over 12 times 3 over 12. 10% of this, then multiply by 3 over 12, you get the value. So if I take 10% times 3 over 12, then subject to 2,500,000, I'm getting 62,500. Then subtract 2 million, that's the answer, getting 2,437,500. Remember, these 2,500,000, we are not going to subject to 10% only, because it was not for the whole year. It was only for 3 months. They were reoccupied on 1st October, October, November, December. So 3 over 12 times the rate times the amount will give you the value. Then subtract the cost from the ID value, you get the balance. The last one, we are having the staff canteen. I've written there the cost, which was 840,000. This was given in the question. But we are told this staff canteen were used from 1st September 2014. It means September, October, November, December, 4 months. So we are going to say 10% multiplied by 4 out of 12, because it was only used for 4 months, September, October, November, December. So you are going to have 10% times 4 out of 12. Then multiply by 840,000. You multiply by 840,000. I'm getting 28,000. Then subtract 840. Subtract 840 from 28. The amount is $8,000. I think we exhausted all the industrial billing reductions. We exhausted all the billing reduction. Now we're going to sum this cost, and also let's sum up the value. Let's sum the value, the IBD value. So if I take 1,200,000 plus 800 plus 600 plus 2,500,000 plus 840, this is coming to 5,940,000. If I add the IBD value, I'm going to have 300,000. 300,000 add to 200,000. Then add to 150,000. Then you add to 9,000. Then you add to 62,500. Then to 28,000. 749,500. 749,500. Now that's all about the industrial billing reduction. We have shown the investment reduction and also the industrial billing reduction. Let's do the last one, wear and tear. Wear and tear. Allow me to wrap so that I show the wear and tear allowance. The wear and tear allowance. Well, this will be the last one. The wear and tear allowance. Let's have the class. We have class 1. Remember class 1, the percentage for class 1 is 37.5%. We have class 2. The percentage for class 2 is 30%. 30%. We also have class 3. Class 3. The percentage for class 3 is 25%. We also have class 4. Class 4, the percentage is 12.5%. Lastly, we have class 5. Class 5. The percentage is 20%. 20%. Now, let's begin with the written down value. Let's begin with the written down value. Written down value. Remember, this was on 1st January 2014. Let's say 1st January 2014. We don't have the written down value. We are not being given. So we just say dash. We are not being given the written down value. We are not being given. So we go to additions. Additions. So let's begin from the question. We have the saloon car. Remember, factory building qualifies for investment reduction. We already used the same with processing machinery. Saloon car. Now we have the saloon car. Remember, saloon car is a class 3. Saloon car is class 3. The amount you have been given is 2,800,000. But I said then a commercial vehicle like Modovia, like saloon car, they are restricted to 2,000,000. From the question, the amount is 2,800,000, but they are restricted to 2,000,000. So we are not going to use 2,800,000. We are going to use the restricted value of, let's say, restricted R of how much? 2,000,000. Then we go, we continue. We have advertising sign. We have the neon, neon advertising, neon advertising sign. That is a class four. That is class four. The amount is 48,000. The amount there is 48,000. We continue. Computers. We have computers. Computers is a class two. Class two. The amount is 150,000. 150,000. Next. Next is delivery van. Delivery van. 960,000. We have delivery van. That is a class three. Of how much? 960,000. Then we have the furniture and fittings. Furniture and fittings. Furniture and fittings. Furniture and fittings. The amount is 200,000. The amount there is, the furniture and fittings, the amount there is 200,000. 200,000. 200,000. Then we have the computer software. Remember, water tank and water pump, we already used them. Computer software. Computer software. Computer software. Remember, we said the software is class 5. That's class. Sorry, I have written the furniture and fitting in the wrong class. So they are not class 5, they are class 4. The first class 4 was the neon advertising sign, which is 48,000. Then the furniture and fittings of 200,000. So sorry, they are not class 5, they are class 4. Class 4. Now the software now is class 5. The amount for software is 120,000. 120,000. Continue. Lorry 3 ton. We have the lorry. Lorry 3 ton. 3 ton. The amount is 2,750,000. 2,750,000. Lorry, anything more than 1 ton is class 1. They are heavy. Class 1. So lorry 3 ton is a class 1. So we are done with the first part. If you look at additional information number 3, we are told the Salunta was disposed of on 1st December 2014 for 1,800,000. Before we go to this, we say disposal, after we have written the addition values, if there is no any other addition value, now we less the disposal. Say disposal. Disposal. So we have Salunta. Salunta of 1,800,000. We are told the Salunta was disposed on 1st December for 1,800,000. We are not going to use the 1,800,000. We are going to calculate the disposal. So we say we calculate for disposal. We take the restricted value. The restricted value was 2,000,000. We take the restricted value of 2,000,000. Then we divide with the initial cost. If I remember, the initial cost for Salunta was 2,800,000. 2,800,000. So we divide the 2,800,000. Then we multiply by the disposal value. We are told we disposed on 1st December for 1,800,000. 1,800,000. This will give us the disposal value. I take 2,000,000. 2,000,000. I divide with 2,800,000. Then multiply by 1,800,000. I'm getting 1,285,000. So nearest 714. 1,285,714. Now that's what we are going to write here as a disposal. 1,285,714. So I can wrap there. You know how we calculated. We take the restricted, we divide with the usual amount, then multiply by the disposal value. Then now we get the total for each class.
Obviously, this one, there was no disposal for this. There was no disposal for all of them. Now, so we have here 2,750,000. Here we have 150,000. Then the for this we're going to take 200,000. Then add to 960,000. Then subtract 1,285,714. We take 2 million. $2 million add to 960,000. Then subtract 1,285,714. I'm getting 1,674,286. Total for this will be 48,000 plus 200 will come to 248,000. Total for this is 120,000. Now we subject now to wear and tear. We say here wear and tear. The wear and tear for class 1 is 37.5. Now we take 2,750,000, then multiply by 37.5%. So we take 2,750,000 times 37.5 divided by 100. The amount here is, the wear and tear is 1,031,250. We do the same for class 2. We take 30% of 150, 30 over 100, multiply by 150,000. I'm getting 45,000. Then we do the same for class 3. 25%, 25 divided by 100, multiplied by 1,674,286. The amount is coming here to 418,572 to the nearest 418,572. Then we take 12.5 times 248,000. We take 12.5 divided by 100, subject to 248,000. I'm getting 31,000. So for class 5, 20 divided by 100. Then subject to multiply by 120,000. The amount here is 24. Now we are going to get the written down value as at 31st. Remember, this was 1st January. As 31st January 2014, we subtract 2,750,000 from 1,031,250. Amount here is 1,718,750. We do the same for this. 150 minus 45, 105,000. Then we take 1,674,286, subtract 418,572, getting 1,255,714. 240, last three, 248 minus 31. 217,000. 120 minus 24, 96,000. So that's all about this question. We have shown the investment reduction, the industrial building reduction, and wear and tear. I hope you enjoy it, and it's very easy and simple. I hope. See you in the next class. Thank you for watching.